Given the choice, whether to rule a corrupt and failing empire, or to challenge the fates for another throw, a better throw against one's destiny, what was a king to do? Only match, move by move, the machinations of fate, and thus defy the tyrannous stars. So I returned to the sanctuary of my enemy, the fortress of the Sarafan Brotherhood, deemed impossible for any man to penetrate. Impossible for any man. Deep within these walls, my prey awaited. Mobius, the time streamer, deceiver and eternal gamester, using living beings as his pawns.
In the end, we'd rooted out an entire nest of the fiends.
But we had swept that area already.
Not well enough, but no matter. We purged every last one of that probe with fire, may their souls now rest.
Lord Mobius will be pleased.
It was time for Mobius to answer a few questions. I hoped for his sake to find him in a forthcoming mood.
Help me! Oh, please, no!
From time to time, It is necessary to feed. And the unusual event of a feast prepared by the Seraphan must be savored.
What was that?
The touch of water is like acid to a vampire. I had to find another way to pass. This passage undoubtedly led to the Time Streamer. My prey was nearly in my grasp. But the door had been sealed by a blessed barrier. As I approached, the Reaver resonated in response. Perhaps its dark sorcery could dispel these holy barriers.
Thank you.
locked. What a love of doors these pathetic humans have. This emblem was unmistakably of vampire origin and designed to enhance the Reaver's power. But this coincidence seemed too convenient. Mobius clearly meant for me to find it.
Sound the alarm!
Vampire!
Don't let him escape!
Surround him! Surrender, fiend, and we will promise you an easy death.
I could promise you the same, but it would be a lie. This barrier had a curious resonating effect on the Reaver. This door had been equipped with a singular lock, requiring an unusual key. Somehow, I would find it.